You won't believe what this new AI can create with just a few words. Now, I know a lot of people get confused when it comes to creating certain prompts or telling the AI to create a certain image for you. It's very simple. I like to keep it straight and simple to the point. That way, it doesn't confuse you at all. And I show you a perfect example in this video, and you'll be amazed what type of images this AI creates for you. Create the image, upscale the image, and save it in any type of format you want, and then remove the background. Now give this video a thumbs up. Let's get into the content.
When it comes to doing a t-shirt research online, my favorite tool to use is Merch Informer. Let me show you one of the coolest features inside of this tool to help you find top selling niches. I come over here to product research on the left hand side, brings a little drop down. We're going to be using Merch Hunter and Movers and Shakers. We pop open a tab for Movers and Shakers and Merch Hunter. So, for example, let's say we're coming in here into Movers and Shakers, and this is cool because there's a lot of good designs that are shared in here daily, and just new ideas that you come in here and you're going to see. And right below, you're going to see these are the BSRs. And you know, if it goes up, makes a sell, it drops down. When it goes up and it drops down, it makes a sell. Same thing, drop down, make a sell. So the more of the up and down we see going on, the better. Short, so it's short niche, like short people niche, I'm thinking that one. Let's go down to, let's say for example, let's say funny alien Halloween costume. You can see what they did here. But let's take the, it's gonna pop up, open up here on Amazon. That's a cool thing too. So all these are clickable. Come over here, let's take that and let's come over here into the keywords of Merch Hunter. So, and you can also to exclude all these brands if you're, you know, wanna keep out Disney, Star Wars, which is really cool. But we're gonna go ahead and just keep category shirts, marketplace US, top 100. And you can filter any of these by using this, and then we're gonna hit search. This is all personal preference, but for this example, I'm gonna show you. And it's gonna basically take that keyword alien, and it's going to filter all this. And usually you would have to dig into amazon.com and just take out all kinds of, you know, different, how would you say that, different, like different listings, go through the whole thing and making sure that the algorithm is giving you this and that. Now we're looking at BSRs. A lot of these BSRs, look at this, these BSRs are crushing. 19,000, 19,000, 14,000, 23,000, 27,000, 27,000. But it's just giving you anything with the keyword alien in the title. It's basically ripping it from amazon.com, and but making it all organized for you. It's nice and clean right here. These are all Amazon merch products, right? Down to the middle of the page, we're still 50K BSR. That's a good sign. That means that there is a demand inside of this niche. But there's a lot of inspiration that you can get from this. Just by looking at all this, there's a ton of good inspiration that can be done here. Look at this one. Get the alien hugging the cat, which is pretty cool. So, yeah, it's cool. So this is how, you know, you can do research and come up with different inspiration, find the trending ideas in a niche, which is very, very big for you as if you're a designer or if you're trying to come up with new ideas. This is an awesome way to leverage Movers and Shakers and Merch Hunter inside of Merch Informer. All right, so the new AI creator, Dall-E 3, just came out. So what it is, it's an image creator. This is powered right here. I have this inside of Microsoft Bing, but it says powered by Dall-E 3. And another way that you can get it is inside of ChatGPT. You have to have the premium version with ChatGPT, pay $20 a month, and that's the other way that you can get it. But as far as I know, I created a few images in here already, and it comes out pretty freaking clean, right? And I just want you to think about, you know, how you can use this for your business. As far as, you know, I create a lot of content on selling t-shirts online for like print on demand, KDP, Amazon merch. There's a few different things when it comes to creating, you know, images and what you can use them for, right? And the main thing is, when you're using any of this stuff, is just keeping up to date with certain platforms with their AI rules, right? So like, say for example, like if you're selling t-shirt designs on Amazon merch and all of a sudden they say, hey, you cannot use AI images, that's a big no-no, you can't use it. That's one thing that you want to make sure that you're following, because at this time and point, it's for most of the print-on-demand platforms, let's say like Redbubble, Etsy. I know that KDP has a few updated rules with AI, using AI, and Amazon merch is TeePublic and pretty much all the platforms. But you know, as time goes along, they may update it because it's still fairly new, but it's like the big thing right now. And I don't see it going anywhere anytime soon. So if you haven't been messing with it, I'd recommend you start testing this out. You're gonna see that you have 24 boosts for today. So those are the tokens that I have available right there. Now, for example, let's come over here, let's type in Santa. We're going to do something that's trending. One way that you can do research too is using Merch Informer. Merch Informer is a really cool tool that I personally like to use when it comes to doing t-shirt design research or just research in general for designs, coming up with different inspiration, different niches. It's a really, really cool tool to use. So a lot of the research that I do personally on my YouTube channel is done with Merch Informer. So keep that in mind. But an idea would be Santa Claus skate. Let's do this. Santa Claus skate. Boarding with a boombox on his shoulder. Gold chains on Santa's neck. And then what we're gonna do is gonna go ahead and type in vector, and you can mix this up too. We'll do a few different things. Say vector t-shirt. Just say vector, vector t-shirt design. We'll go ahead and do that. Or just put vector. So now this is something to keep in mind. So vector t-shirt design, you can also do not, you can also take this out, for example, and then you can put like sticker. You can put like black background. There's a few things that you can edit here, but, or maybe you can even, so with the sticker, usually you kind of just do that white outline around the sticker, which is really cool because it's easy to edit out the background, right? So if you want to use it for a different design or come up with a different idea, you can do that. So we got that done right there. Let's go ahead and see what this comes out with the vector t-shirt. We're good. Let's go ahead and create something and see what it does. So it's populating. You're going to see that it's populating. Let it take its time. Damn. God dang. Now, one thing that I've been noticing too, it's like trying to put the design on a t-shirt for us. So maybe just put like vector design. That's what I'm trying to think about. That's what I'm trying to, you know, when it comes to this, it'd be part of just vector design. Look at that design. Thing is, that's pretty clean. That's dope. The hands down, you know, with Midjourney, right? A lot of the hands and like the face and stuff like that. But look at the detail work. This is clean. This is freaking, look at that, dude. That's dope. Pretty clean. Look at that. Dang. Even the hands too, right? Face, all the shadowing. I'm not sure what's going on here, but it's still like, you know, still freaking clean. Look at the detail work. That's all right. Now let's say, like, instead of using vectors, just try sticker. Hit create. See what happens. Literally just, like I said, just taking out that one keyword, set of t-shirt, using use sticker instead and see what populates. That's clean. Look at that. Some good stuff, huh? This is crazy. I'm just like looking at this stuff like, damn, this is just cool. And you can see, like, because when you do sticker, you see that outline, that's what it's doing. So it makes it easier for you. Like, say if you want to put this on Revable, I've sold tons and tons of stickers on Revable, and this will be a good example to put a, you know, come up with a certain design over there. I think it would be a really, really good idea when it comes to, you know, thinking of a design and putting, you know, different stickers on Redbubble. This can be one way, you know, that you can do that. This is just sick. Now, let's go ahead and download the image. I'm gonna show you how to take out the background of the image. And you, most of the time too, just keep in mind, like when you're looking at any, when you're doing any of this stuff, just all about testing, right? Black background, right? You can even put that in. And then put like, just see if you want to just put a vector or it's just sticker. Let's say just sticker, hit sticker, hit enter and see what it populates for us. And then one more thing. Let me show you one more thing. Look at that. Clean. Let's do surfing. All right. But let's check this out real fast. Damn. God, look at that. That is freaking, look how dope that is. That's amazing. And then you can save and download and we'll get to that in a bit. But just look at that, man. That, look how freaking. All right, let's do the surfing one. Create. And it's amazing because that it's creating these within, like, doing it within seconds, man. Like, you're getting this type of artwork done in seconds. That's clean. It kind of did like a little skateboard right there. Do I have skateboard in there? Put sound of surfing. Yeah. Just making sure I didn't put skateboard in. Probably have to edit something out of there, but this one's clean. That's dope too. Like, dang. All right, so let's go ahead and let's download one of these images and just take out the background. So I'll show you guys, you know, how to take out the background. All right, so now let's go ahead and take this image right here. I have this one. This is probably like one of my favorite ones that it's created. I'm gonna go ahead and hit download, and then it's gonna go ahead and download that image. All right, so I downloaded that image on my PC. I'm gonna come over here to vectorizer.ai. I'm gonna drag that image that I just downloaded, right? You're gonna see it right here. So that image that I just downloaded, I'm gonna go ahead and drag and drop it over there. And as I'm over here into vectorizer.ai, it's processing and uploading over here. And this is a really, really awesome tool to use if you're going to, you know, convert it into an SVG or if you're going to convert it into a PNG. It does a few different things, right? And it's all based on your personal preference because everyone's going to be doing a different thing. Just showing you different ways to, you know, upscale the image and without pixelating it or doing anything like that. So here's the original images on the left. Vectorizer 8.ai is the results are on the right. Now, as we come over here, we're going to go ahead and click download. And as we click download, right, to your personal preference, the file format, it's up to you. If you're going to download it like an SVG, you can do that. EPS, PDF, DXF. So for this example, let's go ahead and download it into a PNG, or you can even download it into an SVG, right? Which was really cool because it makes pretty much the whole image all editable. And it's up to you how you're gonna do that. But let's go ahead and just download it into a PNG. All right, now as we download that into a PNG, it's downloaded to the computer. Let me show you the image. So this is the PNG, pop that up. You can see it's right there. So this is a PNG file, right? Now there's a few different ways that you can take out the background. All right, the first way I'm going to show you is inside of Photopea, photopea.com. This one's a free web-based website. It's like almost like a Photoshop, but it's called Photopea. And it's cool because it's web-based, right? You don't have to worry about, you know, opening up a software and crashing your computer. I know how it feels when it comes to that. And now what we're going to do is going to go ahead and take out this background. We're going to go over here and we're going to go ahead and click remove background. All right, and it did a pretty good job at removing the background, as you can see, right? It took it all out. And all I did was hit select and remove background. Now, this part right here is, you're gonna see that little black part right there. Now, if I wanted to erase that part, I just went over here and clicked on the magic eraser and just highlighted that black part and it took it out. So it was pretty simple over here in Photopea. Just came over here, remove background, and it removed the whole background for me. And now I can just, you know, come over here like this. I can move that image around if I want to, or even add some text inside of here. You can add text in here, put text over the image if you wanted to. But then if you're done with that, you're going to come over here to export as file, export as, and then hit PNG and go ahead and save. Now it's saved. Let me go ahead and pop it up. It's right there and boom, right? So there it is right there. That's that PNG with how I removed the background. Yeah. Now, another way is going to be Canva. Canva, I'm pretty sure you heard of Canva. Canva is a really cool tool if you're going to be using any, doing any type of, you know, video editing. You can do a ton in here. Social media posting, creating designs. The list goes on and on and on and on. Oops, the list goes on and on and on. But what we're going to do is going to go ahead and upload that original PNG file. That's the one right here. Using a design, custom design, create this new design. And it's going to populate a new window for us. And what we're going to do is come over here. We're going to remove that background, right? So come over here to edit photo. I click edit photo. Then it says BG remover. We're just going to hit remove background. And boom, it removed the whole background too as well. And that's a cool thing too. Just keep in mind that little trick. White background, black background, green background. Whatever your personal preference is when it comes to removing the background. It's all up to you at the end of the day. And what I mean by that is, when I came over here, the black background, right? I put that in there for a reason. So it makes it easier when we're coming over to any type of photo editor. It's easy to remove that background, right? Now there's that little black spot right there. I can hit that magic erase and I can just highlight that part right there and boom, it erased it right there. So you can see that it erased right there, which is really cool. You can see how cool that is and how that worked, right? And then the same thing with this one too. You see the backgrounds removed, right? And the cool thing about this, you can even, you know, if you want to downsize it, I can even, you know, downsize it and even add different types of text inside of here, which is really cool. There's a ton that can be done over here. And then come over here to download. And as I hit download, we can do a transparent background if you want, or your personal preference, however you want. You can do a different size if you want to do a different size. So I just hit download transparent background and it's downloading. Boom. And downloaded. Then I come over here to my downloads. There's the image. Boom, right? Really cool. So you can see exactly what I did right there using Dall-E 3, and it was a Microsoft Bing. Like I said, you can use ChatGPT and Dall-E 3, and then Microsoft Bing with Dall-E 3 too as well. And which is really cool, right? So, but the main thing with ChatGPT, you have to pay for their premium version, which is $20 a month for you to get access to that. This one right here with Microsoft Bing, I just came over here and signed up for it. I got access to it. I'm gonna have the links down below in the description. So if you wanna go ahead and start using this, testing it out, you do so yourself and you can see how I upscaled the image and you can see how I removed the background. Pretty simple, but really, really cool. Now, if you come over here and look at the commercial use for Bing, what I did was come over here and type it, just find it on the page, and it pops up over here, number 7, and it says subject for your compliance with this agreement, the Microsoft service agreement, and our content policy. You may use creations outside of the online services for any legal, personal, non-commercial purposes. So you cannot use this for commercial use. So you can use it for inspiration and other things like that. And like personal use, if you're using it for yourself, if you're using like for some type of slideshow, you know what I mean? Anything like that, as long as you're using it for yourself and then obviously non-commercial purpose. Now, with that being said, Dall-E 3 inside of ChatGPT, from my understanding that it is, you can use it for commercial use. So you can use it on print on demand and stuff like that on if you're selling online. But if you're using it inside of Bing AI, right, as of right now, they're not allowing you to use it for commercial use, which is going to be really interesting. Curious to see how that plays out, but let me give you another idea to create another video on ChatGPT with Dall-E 3.
If you want to come up with unlimited design ideas, watch this video right here. I take you step by step on how to leverage an AI tool to help you come up with unique and creative ideas. Thank you very much for watching. Give this video a thumbs up.